You know, this is really something I'm passionate about when you think about California continuing to be a leader in innovation, and certainly what our entire planet is undergoing right now relative to how we are going to work together to sustain it. And you know, I wear many hats. Obviously, I'm the CFO of California, so I have my green eye shade duties, but it's really the policy reach that I have where we've been able to make, I think, some incredible progress relative to elevating the importance of this issue in terms of sustainability. But also, I have to say that it's been really, finally, nice to have some focus on ocean protection, ocean resources, and that's been a main issue here in California. My policy reach includes serving on the two largest public pension boards in the United States, CalPERS and CalSTRS, where we do really consider sustainability issues in our investments. And it's been a way to actually try to engage the corporate sector with respect to its responsibility on helping us to achieve our sustainable development goals. And then also, I chair the State Lands Commission in every alternate years with our Lieutenant Governor. I'm currently the chair this year. But this is really where the state's work has culminated. And as Constance mentioned in her remarks, you know, this whole issue of cooperation is so critical. We have so many state agencies and local agencies that really are working towards the same goals, and yet you know, we are not sharing best practices. We are not coming together in terms of the strengths that we each have to really meet our goals. And I think the work going forward is really about that. And we know also that as our economy continues to become more diverse, that when we talk about particularly the ocean economy and the maritime economy, that it's you know, really shifting in terms of the broader array of industries that it could encompass. And so I'm just very glad to be on this panel to really share a lot of what's developing in California, but also have among us experts who are already down that path.
Betty, thank you very much. Constance, we'll come back down this way, and in recognizing that you have really explored and explained quite rigorously for Portugal's perspective, can you give us a sense of how this all started in Portugal? Because we can see where this has landed, and it is a rather remarkable and well-developed policy, and you have many tools in place for that policy. Could you describe, perhaps maybe 10 years ago or so, where Portugal was, and then how the effort and the energy was constructed in order to deliver the types of policies that Portugal has today?
Yes, Portugal is a maritime nation, but we didn't have a national ocean strategy that brings us an integrated view. So we started with a national ocean policy in 2006. It was the first strategy. That strategy was launched at that time in the Ministry of Defense. But after that, we need to improve and upgrade that strategy with an action plan and with an alignment with financing. And that moves the National Ocean Strategy for the economic perspective, and the new strategy, the upgrade strategy, was launched for the Ministry of Sea, outside the Ministry of Defense. That is a historic evolution in Portugal. And this new strategy brings a development model. We was with the UN conference that time for sustainable development in Rio, the Rio Plus 20. And that was also a way to align with the international agendas, with sustainable development. We propose a model for development, not just the sectorial, but an integrated view with a goal for sustainable development, even at that time. And it was building the puzzle to join people, to join sectors. And it is important to have a broad view, because in our day-to-day, we see just the small things. But when we come to the more broad strategy, we can see how the stakeholders are working, how we can use the best we have in Portugal, because we have a lot of skills in many other sectors, but they were disconnected. they are not working. For example, we didn't have a cluster. We didn't have a recognized organization to talk with. And now, in Portugal, the industry, in terms of the ocean economy, is organized. We have someone to talk with, because when we want to, for example, promote this kind of events and work at international level, we need to have a cluster, an organized cluster. When we need to identify, for example, to present here numbers about our ocean economy, it was a work with our National Ocean Institute, that is the statistical office in Portugal, but we need the cluster. It was the cluster that worked with us to identify where are the stakeholders, what they do, to visit installations, to see how the ports work, to see how it is a shipbuilding industry, because the statistics office don't know, and they need to know, because they have all the information that banks need, that the clusters need to make benchmarking around the world, and we can do that. And that was a path that we have been building, and now we have a ministry for the sea, specifically for the sea. We have a minister that all day she is doing the work for the sea, and that is an important evolution, because we started without the ministries. In the last government we have the Ministry of Sea and Agriculture, and now we have the Minister of Sea with ports, with transportations, and with direct responsibilities on this anchor of the ocean economy, and with a dedicated fund, because in the past we worked with other funds, but we, when we detect gaps, we don't have the instrument to fill that gaps. So it's an evolution.
Thank you, thank you. Helly, may I ask you then, in comparison, Norway has certainly been a very proud maritime nation, and I think Norway has been a remarkable leader in pursuing sustainable development goals, particularly in the genesis of Goal 14. And could you give us a sense of where Norway finds itself today, as I think many nations around the world are admiring Norway for investments you've made both domestically and foreign, and how that's really coming to comprise a blue economy for Norway?
Thank you very much and good morning. I'm really honored and enthusiastic and pleased to be here. We are to talk about issues that are very close to my Norwegian heart. And yes, I'm happy to say that as it's already mentioned, we've been a blue economy for a long time, maybe much longer before we knew that that notion actually existed. We have long coastlines, we have bridges on the seas, and we have somehow been able to manage to harvest the bridges on the seas without ruining the oceans. Now you will see offshore fields and fisheries side by side. So in the Norwegian policies that we have, we had this ocean strategy that was mentioned earlier today, which was launched last year. The management of resources in a sustainable way is an extremely important part of it, including cross-sectoral plans where all stakeholders are included, including the industries, when we decide on decision-based or science-based decisions and management, how to include everybody. Then the other pillar of the national ocean strategy is indeed that in order to be understand what this regular rhythm of the room and which can later become new regulations. At the same time, international regulations has always been key, including the UN regulations and the IMO, of course. But lately, we have also taken much stronger focus on the international policy part of it, because being a leading maritime nation, like an ocean nation as we are, we also need to show our responsibilities internationally. And last year, we launched a strategy or a white paper to Parliament, and that's from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, on the role of the oceans in Norwegian foreign policy and development policy. That actually means that we focus in particular on blue economy, how to have blue economy as a strengthened part of development policy. There's no reason why other countries could not also prosper and gain from blue economy the way we have. And to that extent, we have several development programs. I'm not going into detail, but it's really the focus of our innovation development policy. Clean options has been mentioned several times. It's a precondition for being able to use the oceans in order to achieve the SDGs in general, as we know. And there again, we have some specific initiatives on the Norwegian side regarding reducing, trying to do away with marine waste plastics in developing countries, in particular, where the need for this is maybe the most, because it's their problems are the biggest. And we just recently initiated and is part of multi stakeholder trust fund, the World Bank, where we contribute money together with other states for the same purpose. Last but not least, we don't have a minister for disease, but we have a very active prime minister, Anna Solberg. She is vice chair to the UN Advocates for Sustainability, and she has launched a high level panel with the participation of the coast state heads of government. They have their first meeting during the UN Assembly of September, and they have as their goal to find out the best ways how we can protect, prosper, and produce from the ocean, do all the three things at the same time. She has with her excellent members, like Portugal, like Mexico, small ocean states like Fiji, and they are to come up with recommendations and find a report, which will be launched at the UN Sea Conference, Ocean Conference in Portugal. And they will also have blue papers on their way with the good recommendations on leadership on how to put this high on the agenda. So we try to take this agenda forward, both on a national level and by the help of businesses, not the least, but also on the international level. Also, business is key. There's a close cooperation with the UN agencies, including the envoy of the UN overseas, but not the least, the UN Global Compact Platform on Sustainable Ocean Business that you mentioned, where the businesses indeed contribute a lot to come up with good solutions. Because not business, research, cooperation, and input will not come back.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm going to come back to a couple of things that you raised, but I'd like to ask our audience members to be thinking of the questions that you would like the panelists, and we'll circulate a microphone and anticipate that you'll have an opportunity to answer, or excuse me, to ask questions very shortly here. Secretary General Hutt, could you please explain to us then your views of how Mexico is proceeding towards a blue economy? Given your portfolio of fisheries and aquaculture, I would imagine that you might be focusing your comments in that direction. Issues like sustainability and the ability to prosper economically are often looked at as in conflict, but in other places we haven't quite seen how they can be quite rationally harmonized. So I invite your comments as to how Mexico, and in particular the state of Baja, has been pursuing a blue economy.
Thank you very much. Good morning. It's an honor to be here. can identify the huge potential and opportunities that we have as a state government to go to this new technology. Mexico, I accept that is way behind the new technology issues, but the state of Baja has always been a leader, and we, this administration, this state administration, 3 years ago, we decided to really step up into this new technology with maritime alliance. We are a border state to California and the U.S., so if California and the West Coast of the U.S. are really, really very hard, very serious with this new technology, then Baja California has to be part of this. So we have been working on many, many projects. We have huge natural resources to work in this 1,500 kilometers of coastline. We are number one now in offshore mariculture in Latin America. That has been a very ambitious sector for us as a state government, especially on the bluefin tuna. And we have a very active governor, Mr. Vega de la Madrid, that understands the blue technology. Like you guys mentioned before, blue technology is wet. So we have a lot of water around our state, and we will always work and look at this potential and these opportunities in the middle budget to really develop.
Thank you very much.